Hello, today we plan to discuss comparison, how to express comparison in English. To understand it easily, we will take three different situations. In the first situation, there are only two items. You can see there are two trees here. Tree A is taller than tree B. Similarly, here you can see two boxes. Box A is bigger than box B. So when there are only two items compared, then it's very easy. Bigger than, smaller than, faster than, taller than, such expressions we can use. We can also say it the other way around. For example, tree B is not as tall as tree A. Similarly, box B is not as big as A. Now, when we have more than two items, then there are two possibilities. One, here you can see all these are marbles, and marble A is different from the rest. So this is one type of situation. So here we can say A is the biggest marble of all. You can clearly see A is the biggest marble of all. You can convey the same message by saying A is bigger than any other marble. That also conveys the same message. And you can also see clearly that no other marble is as big as A. So here A is a unique marble, different from the rest. So in this type of situation, we use the biggest for superlative degree, bigger than for comparative, and as big as or so big as for positive. So A is the biggest marble of all, A is bigger than any other marble, and no other marble is as big as A. Now sometimes we have a situation in which not just one item is different from the rest, but a small group is different from the rest. So here you can see there are three marbles, A, B and C. They are different from the rest. So here, because these A, B and C, they are similar to each other, I cannot say A is the biggest marble of all, because that sentence will be wrong when we see B and C. So here I have to say A is one of the biggest marbles. It is not the biggest, but it is one of the biggest. That means there are a few others like A. The same sentence you can also say for B also. B is one of the biggest marbles, or C is one of the biggest marbles. But right now we are talking about A. So A is one of the biggest marbles. Now for comparative, we can say A is bigger than most other marbles. Not any other marble, but most other marbles. Because if we say A is bigger than any other marble, then it will be wrong for B and C. So we have to say A is bigger than most other marbles. And in positive degree, we have to say very few marbles. In fact, here there are only two. So very few marbles are as big as A. So all these three sentences convey the same message. A is one of the biggest marbles. A is bigger than most of the marbles, and very few marbles are as big as A. Now this is from the grammatical structure point of view, but what about the use? Normally we use this pattern, the best, the fastest, the strongest. We use this pattern when we are talking about facts. So when you say Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the world, nobody can challenge that. It is a fact, right? So for facts you use this, but when you are giving your opinion, for example, if I say Sachin Tendulkar is the best cricketer in the world, then many people may not accept that. Some people might say I have some other cricketer in mind. So when you are giving your opinion, you should use this pattern. Sachin Tendulkar is one of the best cricketers. Then people will say, okay, I have this person in mind. So that is also taken care of. So normally for facts, we use this pattern, and for opinions, we use one of kind. So this type of patterns. I hope this video helps you to convey your messages of comparison. If you want more such videos, you can visit our website www.fluentlingua.com. You can also visit our YouTube channel, Fluentlingua. Thank you very much.